Hi guys, welcome to the Healthcare Channel. Today's video we'll talk about how to control unsafe abortion. Unsafe abortion is one of the most causes of maternal mortality and severe morbidity in countries with restrictive abortion laws. In 2007, Healthcare created a working party on the prevention of unsafe abortion and its consequences, WGPUA. This led to a healthcare initiative thereupon AIM, which has the active participation of 43 healthcare member societies. The WGPUA has recommended that the plans of action of the countries participating within the initiative consider several levels of prevention shown to possess the potential to successfully reduce unsafe abortions: 1. Primary prevention of unintended pregnancy and induced abortion. 2. Secondary prevention to make sure the security of an abortion procedure that would not be avoided. 3. Tertiary prevention of further complications of an unsafe abortion procedure that has taken place already through high-quality post-abortion care. And 4. Quaternary prevention of repeated abortion procedures through post-abortion birth control counseling and contraceptive services. This paper reviews these levels of prevention and therefore the evidence that they will be effective. 1. Introduction. It is documented that unsafe abortion is one of the most causes of maternal mortality and severe morbidity in countries with restrictive abortion laws. 1.2. Although some countries show signs of important decreases in abortion-related maternal mortality, an equivalent has not happened in other less developed countries. Additionally, while the entire number of induced abortions has decreased over recent years, the amount of unsafe abortions has increased from on the brink of 20 million to just about 22 million per annum. 3.4. This situation motivated Healthcare to make a working party on the prevention of unsafe abortion and its consequences, WGPUA. This led to a healthcare initiative thereupon AIM, which has the active participation of 43 healthcare member societies. Each participating national society has worked alongside representatives of their respective Ministry of Health and a variety of national and international organizations, first by completing a situational analysis of unsafe abortion and second by developing an idea of action for the prevention of unsafe abortion. 5. The WGPUA has recommended that the plans of action consider the amount of prevention that have the potential to successfully reduce unsafe abortions. This paper reviews these levels of prevention and therefore the evidence that they will be effective. 2. Primary prevention of unsafe abortion. The effectiveness of the increased use of contraception on the abortion rate has been shown by prospective operational studies and lots of observational studies throughout the planet. 6. The clearest example has been the dramatic drop by the abortion rate in Eastern Europe following the introduction and increasing adoption of effective contraceptives in those countries in recent years. 2. Recent data suggest, however, that there's an excellent difference in effectiveness during perfect use compared with typical use of a number of the foremost popular contraceptive methods, like the pill. During perfect use of the pill, only 3 in 1,000 users get pregnant during the primary year, but the speed jumps to 9 per 100 women during the primary year of typical use within the USA. 7. The most reason for this enormous difference may be a failure to stick to the recommended daily intake of the pill and to the right interval between one cycle and therefore the next. In contrast, methods that don't depend upon user adherence, like the copper or hormonal releasing IUD, and contraceptive implants, have low pregnancy rates, less than 1 for every 100 women per year, for both perfect and typical use. 8. The effectiveness of sexuality education schemes on the abortion rate among adolescents is more controversial, in large part because effective programs should suit some minimal conditions and are amid quick access to contraception. Restrictive sexuality education schemes have little chance of success if they are doing not recognize that adolescents are often sexually active, that they ought to be told on the way to protect themselves, which they ought to have access to means of protection. Unbiased programs that include access to contraception are shown to scale back unplanned pregnancies and abortions among adolescents. 9. Another strategy that has the potential to scale back abortion among women already pregnant is to supply social protection to those that would really like to possess the kid but who are abandoned by their partners, rejected by their families, and who see abortion as their only means of survival. Unfortunately, aside from anecdotal examples, there are not many good studies that we are conscious of that show the effectiveness of a social protection strategy. An argument often quoted is that ladies should use adoption services instead of resort to abortion. Many programs offer women with unintended pregnancies the chance to continue their pregnancies to term and provide the babies up for adoption. After birth, the babies are placed in orphanages to attend for foster parents. Unfortunately, the method of adoption is usually complicated and most of those children live a few years without finding a home. Additionally, evidence of the psychological consequences for mothers who have put their children up for adoption has set new doubts about whether this is often an adequate policy or one that does more harm than good. 10.3 Secondary prevention of unsafe abortion. When a lady with hit or miss an unwanted pregnancy has made the choice to terminate that pregnancy, she is going to proceed thereupon intention at any cost. During this situation, the sole thanks to preventing an unsafe abortion are to supply safe services for termination of pregnancy. The International Conference on Population and Development, ICPD, held in Cairo in 1994, includes the subsequent statement in its program of action: in circumstances during which abortion isn't against the law, such abortion should be safe. 11. Very few countries don't allow abortion under any circumstances. However, in many of the countries with restrictive laws, neither women nor health providers are conscious of these circumstances, and most girls don't get a secure, legal abortion, albeit they fulfill the conditions for legal termination of pregnancy. For instance, many countries allow abortion when the pregnancy is the result of rape, but the law isn't implemented because it's not regulated. Many times a judge's conviction of the rapist is required, by which era the pregnancy has long reached term. To our knowledge, only the Brazilian government has established regulations for the care of girls that suffer sexual violence, which include termination of pregnancy when it's the result of rape and therefore the woman requests the termination. 12. Moreover, the Brazilian Ministry of Health is actively promoting that public hospitals provide services that follow these regulations. The above scenario is the exception, however. In most countries with restrictive laws, the shortage of normal procedures or regulations for the implementation of legal termination of pregnancy makes such services practically non-existent and, consequently, women who have the right to access safe abortion often need to resort to unsafe procedures. Even in countries where the law is permissive, like India, Zambia, or South Africa, the complete application of the law has been delayed for several years because the health system isn't prepared to supply these services and there's resistance from providers to supply services within the general public health system. The resistance of physicians to supply abortion services is usually justified by the shortage of clear regulations, and by the fear that their colleagues will discriminate against those that perform abortions within public services. Studies administered in Brazil and other countries have shown that the majority of physicians accept as true with providing abortion in many circumstances. Additionally, if a physician had personal experience of unwanted pregnancy, 4 out of each 5 had terminated the pregnancy. 13. In other circumstances, however, liberalization of the law has been followed by increased access to safe abortion and therefore the rapid reduction of unsafe abortion and related mortality. The foremost dramatic example of this occurred in Romania after the autumn of Nicolae Ceausescu. 14.4 Discussion. We know what should be done to scale back unsafe abortion and its consequences, but there's an excellent chasm between what we all know and what's being done to realize that purpose. The unmet need for contraception remains alarmingly high in many low-resource countries with high unsafe abortion rates and is even greater if we consider the necessity for simpler contraceptive methods. 26. Several factors determine this high rate of unmet need: lack of access to contraceptive methods, discontinuation of funding for contraceptives for a few low-resource countries by major donors, the excessive and unjustifiable cost of a number of the foremost effective and newest methods, logistic problems preventing the endless flow of contraceptives to the outreach clinics, lack of trained providers, regulations that inhibit non-medical professionals from providing all contraceptive methods, and cultural barriers like women's lack of power to require independent decisions. Efforts are being made to beat some or of these barriers, but a greater and more comprehensive commitment from the world's political, economic, and intellectual leaders is required to beat the barriers that limit women's capacity to form decisions about their fertility. To make the abortion that would not be avoided safer is theoretically simple. The adoption of liberal abortion laws that guarantee access to safe abortion should, in theory, eliminate the necessity for unsafe abortion. The resistance to the liberalization of abortion laws remains very strong in many countries, mostly because it's feared that if the abortion laws become more liberal, women will use abortion instead of contraception to manage their fertility. This fear isn't justified, and evidence has shown that the abortion rate doesn't increase after decriminalization of abortion, and may even go down, as has been seen in some countries. 27. What went on in some high-resource countries with liberal laws, like the United Kingdom and Spain, is that these countries have received large numbers of immigrants, and therefore the abortion rate has increased due to the high rate of abortion among this population. In Spain, for instance, almost half, 45%, of the entire number of abortions performed occurred among foreign-born women, although this population makes up only 11% of girls. 28. The reduction within the abortion rate after legalization could also be surprising initially, but is often explained by the massive increase in post-abortion contraception. Before legalization, abortion was clandestine and lots of abortion providers, who made their living by being purchased the illegality of the procedure, weren't curious about preventing repeat abortion. The ladies who consulted after unsafe abortion publicly hospitals often had complications of infection or hemorrhage and future prevention lost relevance. After legalization, pregnancy termination became a part of regular public health care. Women are offered to counsel in birth control and contraceptive methods after abortion, thus reducing the necessity for repeat abortion and decreasing the overall abortion rate. The instance of Mexico City illustrates this. During 2007, the year of liberalization of the law, only 4.0% of girls consulting for post-abortion complications received contraception before discharge from the hospital. In 2008, 52% of girls who underwent legal termination of pregnancy received post-abortion contraception. The proportion rose to 71.9% in 2009-29. Improving post-abortion care involves changes in attitude to both adoptions of latest technologies and removal of the stigma carried by women consulting after abortion. A recent healthcare statement strongly recommended the replacement of sharp curettage and DNC with suction curettage and therefore the use of medicines, for both pregnancy termination and treatment of partial abortion, 30. To increase the utilization of manual suction curettage and misoprostol is an objective included within the plans of action of quite half the countries participating within the healthcare initiative for the prevention of unsafe abortion. However, less consideration is given to a more friendly and sympathetic provider-client interaction. Health providers privately may understand that in certain circumstances women don't see an alternative to abortion, but in the public function give themselves the proper to become police agents, judges, and executors of penalties to women who abort. Healthcare, the International Confederation of Midwives, ICM, and therefore the respective national associations have a difficult but necessary task to perform to enhance this aspect of post-abortion care. Family planning counseling and therefore the provision of contraceptive methods after abortion is often considered a neighborhood of excellent quality post-abortion care. Healthcare has given it a separate position among the strategies to scale back an unsafe abortion because it merits special attention. For many years it's been known that ladies who have had an abortion are at the very best risk of getting a subsequent abortion if they need an unintended pregnancy, 31, however, this component of post-abortion care doesn't receive the stress it merits. Recently, healthcare joined USAID, ICM, and therefore the International Council of Nurses, ICN, to supply a press release entitled, Family Planning, a Key Component of Post-Abortion Care, 32. The relatively small number of nations involved within the healthcare initiative for the prevention of unsafe abortion that include stress on post-abortion contraception in their plans of action is of concern, and efforts are being made to encourage countries to incorporate birth control after abortion as a key objective in their plans of action. In summary, the strategies that effectively prevent unsafe abortion and its consequences are known. We are missing the political will and therefore the understanding that allocating resources to reducing unsafe abortion is an investment that results not only in reduced human loss and suffering but also during a net economic gain for the countries involved. In our next video, we will be talking about how can alcohol increase the risk of tuberculosis and HIV, and please don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more recommendations on health, relationship, lifestyle and other helpful information to form life easier.